Good morning. One of the first things I do as soon as I wake up every day is open both my windows. I would sleep with them open, but it's just too noisy. I did in the summer, mind. When it was hot, I slept with them open. I have a dehumidifier. I've barely used it at all for months, but I think I might have to start again. It's about 20 to 9 on Saturday. My daughter is still fast asleep in her room. I have got a gig later, and this afternoon we've got the gal pals coming around, our local friends. So I'm going to be having a bit of a clean up, go shopping for cakes and that sort of thing. I'm looking for my sockies. I've got chilly legs. They always go up, my trouser legs, in the night. Always. Where are my socks gone? I always go into bed with nice warm socks and then get in. There they are. And then I get warm and take them off. I'm going to have a nice cosy time now on my own, drinking coffee and doing my language learning before I start getting on to my editing, which will be very nice. Looking forward to this. I have just been sitting here for far too long. It's 10:15 already, but I enjoyed every minute of it. Spent absolutely ages doing my language learning. I've gone over to the dark side. I've got memorised as well as Duolingo now. I'm really pushing the boat out. Anyway, they both have their own merits, but we won't dwell on that. I've been drinking coffee, scrolling through social media, posting on Instagram, which I forgot to do the last day or two. I fell off that. I don't know if anybody else is like this. It's a silly thing, really. See, that is shut. You see that blind is shut over there? Is it even showing on camera? Yeah, it's just whited out, look. But anyway, a kitchen blind is shut. I feel like if I don't open the blinds yet, the day hasn't really started, so I'm not obliged to be doing daytime obligations yet. It's silly, isn't it? But it's something I do. And also nobody can see me through the window, of course, which is nice. I can just doss around in my pyjamas. Okay, I'm going to have some breakfast now. Do a little bit more dossing while I eat my breakfast and then get on with something useful. I've been run out of corn cakes or rice cakes for days. I'm eating this extremely stale bread, but I've just microwaved it to soften it a bit. And there's my blueberries and yoghurt. And do you know what? I take it back about the Asda's Morello cherries from the frozen section being lovely and sweet and delicious in your breakfast. This latest batch has been completely different. They are excruciatingly sour and bigger. So when you bite into them, like, it completely overwhelms your senses. You're like, eyes watering, you know, sweat breaking out here on the bridge of your nose with the sourness. So that whole packet, I'm just gonna have to stew with some sugar and make into a pie or something. I cannot have them in my yogurt.
So it's just the blueberries today.
I didn't edit. It's about 10 to 12 now, actually. I'm about to go to Greg's because I want to get some nice treats for the gal pals. The numbers are diminishing. One of them is not able to come already because the daughter's just not feeling very well today, so we're down to one family coming, but there are three of them. I've just got a method in. Ooh. It's to do with the Lisbon bookings. I've managed to get in touch with one of the landlords. Yeah. But I don't know if he's a landlord or a manager. The person that books the bands, and he's just confirmed that they have their own PA. Because if we're flying there, we're not going to be able to take all the miking up gear, you know, all the speakers and monitors and stands and things. It would just be too much, so we can only really gig at places that have a house PA, which means they have that all there already for us to use. And that message just coming in then was yes, we do. Yeah, I haven't got a date yet, but I've established contact and he's going to get back to me, so we're making a little bit of progress. It's the first one, hopefully, of at least three is the minimum that I think we want, or maybe two could be the minimum. Three would be better. And if we can get any more than that, it's a bonus. Right, I'm going to Greg's.
This is what I got from Greg's. Look, they've got bread again. £1.65, I think that was. I'll probably freeze some of it, but yay. Love Greg's bread. So pleased about that. They're not bringing back
that low GI seeded loaf, though. Apparently they are never bringing it back. So the employee told me, I sparked up a whole conversation in the whole shop and all the other customers were coming, joining in, saying, oh yeah, that's why I always used to come to Greg's as well, for the seeded loaf. But no, apparently not. Well, Lidl's do them now anyway, in their bakery section.
I bought cookies for the girls. There are actually 3 girls and 4 cookies, but I'm sure they won't mind sharing the fourth between the 3 of them. And for the grown-ups, only 2 of us. the obligatory custard slices, all yum. Looking forward to those already. I'm gonna have a little bit of a clean up now. I'm gonna clean up the kitchen, what needs doing. And the front room needs a bit of decluttering and just a bit of cleaning up. I've been keeping on top of it this week, believe it or not, I know. I'll tell you what I'm not on top of.
And that's like the little crevices right in the corners, bits on the skirting board, especially where the skirting board is like patterny on the top and there's like a line in there, bits on the door, that's where the dust is. Every time I hoover, I think, oh, next time I hoover, I'll use the attachment brush and do that instead. So the floor gets done, but all the crevices don't. And I noticed my printer's all dusty again.
Doesn't look too bad from this angle, but believe me, close up it does. I don't know if it's something about electrical items attracting it with static or what, but as soon as I clean it, it's just dusty again. Speaking of printers, more music coming out again. I've had an email back about that. You know, I was doing those tune sets yesterday for the Cayley Band. Somebody suggested an alternative tune, so he sent it to me, so I'm printing that out now. And I think it's a good idea. I think it's a better fit. I've just hoovered most of the house. Just finishing up now. I obviously have not done the crevices still. Maybe I will, I don't know. I wonder if my friend would like some. Oh, look, one of those is going bad. I'm gonna fish that out. Well, I don't think my friend's gonna want that one. That can go in the compost. Might as well empty this. Oh, hello, wildlife. Oh, look, finally, we have strawberries and they're covered in slug trails and nibbles. It's not very appetizing, is it, when they do that? These are still looking all right, though. I must say, once you get into the rhythm of it, it can be very therapeutic just picking up random things and putting them where they belong. Why have I put that there? Oh, yeah, I know. It's because I was cleaning the floor. Go back to where you belong, crisp packet. I mean, it's never going to be perfect, but you know. I don't know what's going on here. Look, one tea towel, two, three. And I know what happened here. I was using that instead of the oven mitt because I could feel the temperature of the apple pie thingy through the oven mitt. So I chickened out and used loads of those. Right, I think they're clean enough. They can go back in the cupboard. There's a hole in that one. Never mind. They can go in my folder upstairs. Excuse the cloves on the bed. That's the wrong way up, that one. It's one of those things you can't do with one hand. Creased it all up now. That's going to be all sideways here. I'll have to redo this one eventually. It'll do for now. I could just take it out and put it up the right way temporarily. I'm doing all bleach down the loo and stuff. That looks, that's all right. Now, when I first came to this house, I thought, oh, what an absolute bonus, a jacuzzi. Never would have thought to get one of those, but how amazing. No, it isn't. Because, you see, if you have a bath and it fills above the level of that and you're not having a jacuzzi, well, I'm never having a jacuzzi because, you know, electricity. And also, just the hygiene thing, because the pipes are filling up with the bath water and then unless you flush them through, it's unhygienic and, like, black, monkey yuck stuff builds up in there and then comes out randomly when you're in the bath, unless you keep on top of the hygiene of it. Look, there's a bit of black mank come out of there now. I had a bath this morning and just put a bit of bleach in there and it's been soaking all for the last little while, I don't know, a couple of hours, and I'm just running the jacuzzi a bit to flush it through. So yeah, I would never ever have one again. The place is looking sufficiently civilized. I'm gonna cook a little bit of lunch. My friend is due in 1 hour, so that should just fit nicely. Look, I'm cooking lunch for me and Izzy. Loads of lovely healthy veggies. We've got kale, I think it's kale anyway, pak choi, red pepper, mushrooms, and monge too. I'm gonna have some sliced halloumi with it. I find the sound of that dishwasher really soothing and calming.
This is nearly ready now. I'm feeling very calm and happy. I've got about another 25 minutes before my friend's due, so I'm gonna sit and eat that and enjoy that nice and calmly. Izzy's gonna have hers later because she had her breakfast not long ago. I'm out gigging tonight, so I always like to make sure I've left lots of healthy home-cooked food if I can, if I've had the opportunity to do it. Because, you know, I think she might cook something less healthy otherwise. Oven food, most likely. Anyway, yeah, I'm really looking forward to just sitting down now, having a coffee, and a chat to my friend, because I haven't seen our local friends for weeks because I've been leaving a bit too early on a Saturday for my gigs to be able to meet up with them and, you know, be ready in time for my gigs. So if Izzy's been going on her own to meet them. I am not leaving till about 6:15 tonight, so yay, I could have them over. It's about to turn 6:10. Look, I'm wearing a dress. I'm about to go out and meet Mick. Oh yeah, I've got the right glasses on. Sorry, I thought they were my reading glasses. I have been doing a bit more housework since I last spoke to the camera, and I've also had a walk, and I had my friend over as well. She stayed for a couple of hours. Yeah, it's all been very pleasant and nothing that exceptional. But anyway, we're off to Brecon now.
Not long to go now till we get to the venue. Sheep in the road.
Ooh. We're at the obligatory part where we got like a mile and a half of very narrow country road to go through. That was a Land Rover or something passing us then. Apparently, Sal tells me I need to have my camera on as we're just turning towards the venue because there's a giant cow.
Oh, Sal was right, look. Oh dear, I'm shooting right into the sun. Look, you can see a silhouette of a cow and a sheep. And it says wedding.
Ah, this looks familiar. I think I've been here before, but not recently. With another band, or have I? I don't know now. Oh, there's another purple cow. Well, we've got the gear in. We've kind of physically sat up, but we can't sound check because they're doing speeches in there at the moment. It's a nice place, like a converted barn or something. Apparently we're in a very remote place, so they can make as much noise as they want without disturbing anybody. In that field behind me there, I thought, oh, there's some animals in there. And I thought they were like miniature ponies or something, or Shetland ponies. And I looked closer, and they were two dogs, and they're very big.
And there, you see that black thing? That is a dog. A very big one indeed. With something around its neck, like, I don't know, a wedding bow or something. Can we make him out? Not much. He did a big gruff woof at me just now. He's having a drink out of his water bowl now. Look, it's very pretty set up here, isn't it? Nice little seating area here. I think there'll be a fire pit in there later when it gets dark. There's another one of those concrete cows in the field. And in front of me here we have a big sheep field. And the sun. Oh, whoops, yeah.
Bride and groom said when we arrived, it's a free bar. Help yourself to any drinks you want. It's a nice welcome, isn't it? Anyway, I'm going to go hang out with the other guys. I didn't want to film in there because you would have been able to hear them, you know, privacy and all that. Anyway, I'm going to go back in now. Bye.
Free bar. Yes. That one's been having a free drink of water as well. So it's been dribbling out of its mouth. The speeches have just stopped for 2 seconds, so I can show you where we are. We're here. Look, we've got some very attractive disco balls up there. And look, need a lampshade solution. Got some old fencing supplies going spare. You can, you know, fashion a lovely attractive lampshade out of that.
I'm not sure if we've got any more speeches. We might have, because I think we've only had one or two so far.
Hey, it's like Play School in here. Do you remember Play School, the TV programme? Hasn't been on for a few years. Look, we've got the triangle window. Oh, we can see all sheep through it. That's nice. And we've also got the square window. This is the DJ's bit here. He's going to be on after us. We've just had a whole team of caterers come over and give us one of these each. I've got a spoon in my bag. I'm going to dig it out. I'm going to vlog in the bog. Basically, everyone's busy at the moment. Oh, there's me. Look, I found this woolly hat in my bag. It's been in there since last winter, but it's actually gone a bit cold. We finished the gig already. They're doing a dance now on the dance floor. I think it's like a first dance, you know, except they've had a whole Katie first. But anyway, we've been invited to partake of curry. So that is what we are going to do.
Whoa, there's my Papa Dom, one-handed vlogging again.
Well, it's a glamorous life, isn't it? I've got back in from my gig and I've been hanging my pants out to dry.
We had an extremely nice gig. I have never, ever, in all my career, known a crowd as absolutely hyped for the start of the ceilidh as this lot were, and they just wanted to keep going. And like, normally they like a rest every 2 dances or something for a few minutes to catch their breath, but nope, they just wanted to carry straight on. They were really into it. Absolutely lovely crowd. The curry was very nice as well, and I went and got another Papa Dom. If you'd like to watch more videos from me, do hit the subscribe button and the notification bell, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.